if you're a childless dude who hasn't, you know, sold drugs, robbed anybody, or contributed to the dysfunction that you see in Black America, you have to speak out and use your voice. Because currently, you have these Black feminists with an agenda to basically demonize all Black guys as if all of us are responsible for creating the 70% out of wedlock birth rate. Now, I said it before, 40+% of Black men don't have kids in America. Another 30% are married. So right there, without even going any forward, without even going further, over 70% of Black guys are not responsible for single motherhood. But you listen to these Black feminists, all Black guys are responsible. And this is why, I mean, if you don't got no kids out here, or even if you do got kids, you basically in their lives, teaching them values, structure, and discipline, you got every right to speak out against the bad choices and fathers these single mothers continue to make for their children. A lot of these chicks today want to talk about, you know, how messed up their baby daddy is, or yada, yada, yada. But what people fail to realize is that right now, as we speak, you got another generation of Black boys ages 6 to 17 being raised by single Black mothers right now. Let's forget about the fucked up Black dudes that were born after during the 80s and, you know, 70s and the 90s. Forget about them for a second. Let's just focus on these young Black boys being raised by single mothers right now that are like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. How are those youngsters going to be any different or raised any different than the previous generation of Black dudes raised by self-hating, racially dead single moms that pick losers? Again, the Black single mothers today, right now, that are raising little boys, how are they going to raise a different generation of boys than the previous? They're not going to. And the same bitches 20 years from now are going to be complaining about the little bastards they raised today that are racially dead, no racial pride. So look, single motherhood is poison to Black America. Because we can fucking exclude the losers of today right now that are adults. Fuck it, let's exclude them. Just focus on the youngsters right now being raised. They are being raised by single mothers who did what their mother did, picked a loser to get pregnant by. And these single mothers today, right now, these Black bitches you see on World Star, these ignorant ghetto Black bitches, they are raising the next generation of little Black boys right now that will grow up with no racial pride. They will grow up to join gangs. They will grow up to be the degenerate loser that, you know, the previous cohort that raised them were. And that's what bothers me, because it's like, once you realize there's a problem and you see that problem, you work in ways to prevent that problem from happening. But that's not the case for Black America. And the main reason for this is because a lot of Black dudes, for example, like myself, who were childless in their, you know, 20s and younger or older, a lot of us don't fucking speak out and say what the fucking truth is. Because, you know, you may have a fucking brother or a cousin who was a degenerate loser like Pookie or Ray Ray or some shit. And you feel as though, I don't want to be hard on my cousin or my family. Look, fuck you, man. You can't think like that. You got to understand something. These Black feminists are fucking hell-bent on destroying the entire fucking Black male leadership population. They're just hell-bent. Regardless of how good you are, of how bad you are, their just whole agenda is be like, fuck it. Even if you didn't contribute to single motherhood, you ain't shit. And that's what the problem is. You can't sit back and allow somebody to blame you for something that you did not contribute to. And I hate when motherfuckers be like, hey, it's all of our responsibility. It's all of our responsibility. No, it's not. They try to say, all black men messed up. We all have a part in this. No, we don't. I haven't created no bastard babies. I haven't made no babies and walked out on them. I haven't robbed anybody in black America. I haven't sold drugs to black America. I haven't destroyed black families. So I haven't contributed to no problem. So I'm not a part of the problem. Don't try to lump me in with the loser degenerates who caused the problem. And that's what motherfuckers want to do. That's what the black feminists want to do. That's what the Pookies and Ray Rays want to do. We're all niggas. We're all in this together. Fuck out of here. After y'all motherfuckers fucked this shit up, you want to point to decent black guys and say, hey, come over here, man. We're all niggas, man. We're all together. I'm not no nigga. I'm a black African. My dad gave me an identity. And I tell these dudes this shit when they try to call me that shit. This is why I'm not trying to unite and just be cool with every motherfucking black person. Because there's always an agenda behind it. They want to lump you with them because the pain of depression and reality hits them so hard. They want as many people to be down there on the bottom, fucked up, just like them. So they're going to say, we're all niggas. Or they're going to say this, white people see you the same way. I don't give a fuck how white motherfuckers see me. Because at the end of the day, I can compete with the best of the motherfuckers and blow them out the water. Again, I don't give a fuck what a white person thinks of me. Because at the end of the day, I can compete against the best of them and blow them out the water. Dolo, by myself. I'm one of those kind of black guys. I don't got to attach myself to black losers and feel good. No, I don't need to do that shit. Because at the end of the day, that's a liability to me. Why am I out here competing and beating these white boys and then trying to side with a loser like Pookie and Ray Ray, who's not even about progressing? If anything, Pookie and Ray Ray confirm the propaganda these fucking racists put out there. You motherfuckers got low IQs. You dumb motherfuckers are just out here selling drugs, sagging your pants, blah, blah, blah. Pookie and Ray Ray are confirming what these white supremacists say about us. So why would I want to even fuck with a Pookie and Ray Ray? A bunch of, you know, inept fucking just motherfuckers that can't even control their own future. Why would I fuck with you? Knowing goddamn well you prove every negative stereotype these racist Nazis are putting out there. Fuck out of here. I'm going to distinguish myself from these degenerate losers. You got to. You cannot align yourself with these loser-ass black guys or defend them because it's not logical. You cannot make a logical argument for what black men are doing to each other in Chicago. You can't. When Ben Shapiro makes his arguments, you cannot defend against that because at the end of the day, black folks, 98% of black folks' problems are self-inflicted. Again, at the end of the day, when you look at it and you really are honest with yourself, you're going to see that 98% of black America's problems are self-inflicted. Me saying that, does that mean I'm letting white folks off the hook for Jim Crow laws and black codes that prevented generational wealth from being passed down? No. But I'm logical and smart enough to see how we have enough internal enemies within our race to prevent any progress. So why would I even waste my time trying to confront a white supremacist or argue with him or defend dumbass black motherfuckers? Fuck out of here. I'm not defending Bonquisha or Pookie. You motherfuckers are a disgrace. I'd rather see you fuckers sterilized and castrated. I swear to God, man, because a lot of these motherfuckers don't want to change. You tell them the truth. You tell them what's going on. A lot of us want to just put our heads in the sand and pretend like nothing's happening. it's going to get to a point to where it's going to be too late for Pookie and Ray Ray. The way society's moving forward right now, it's going to be too late for these motherfuckers. And see, the key is, man, the key is, listen, I'm going to tell you this. Don't dumb yourself down. Too many black guys are dumbing themselves down to appeal to Pookies and Ray Rays. You see it on YouTube with these fucking YouTube content creators. Nigga, nigga, nigga this, nigga that. Every other word. I got respect for O'Shea Duke Jackson, but, I mean, a medical doctor and you using nigga, nigga, nigga? Fuck out of here. Who was their fucking doctor using the word nigga? You walk into an office, right? And you hear your doctor using the word nigga. How much confidence are you going to have in this medical doctor? And O'Shea claims to be going for his medical, whatever. Look, black men with an education need to stop dumbing themselves down to appeal and relate to the lowest common denominator or the lowest denominator in black America. That's what all these fucking so-called educated black guys be trying to do on YouTube. Try dumbing themselves down to Pookie's level instead of forcing Pookie to come to your level. You gotta do that, you dumb motherfuckers. And that bothers me, man. I mean, look, O'Shea, I mean, look, his agenda is all about, you know, bringing black men together, blah, blah, blah. I respect that shit. But you can't be talking about you going to school to be a medical doctor and you using the word nigga, nigga, nigga every other word. What if your dentist used the word nigga every other word? What if you went in for a surgery and you heard motherfuckers using the word nigga? When I hear the word nigga, I think of the most ignorant, this fucking loser ass type of black guy possible. A black dude with no fucking structure, discipline, or just no vision, just... I just get the opinion that this black guy has no identity and basically he just doesn't care for himself. Because when you use the word nigga, basically you're saying to yourself, I'm going to dehumanize you. That's what black men are doing. When you use the word nigga, you're dehumanizing your fellow black man. And that's why it's so easy for us to kill each other. Let's go kill this nigga. Let's go kill this nigga. That's what the Klan would say. The KKK would say. Now, if you said, let's go kill this black man, that's gonna hit your emotion. That's gonna hit your conscience quick. But when you say, let's go kill this nigga, oh, I mean, a nigga's not human. Let's go kill this motherfucker. And see, black men have been conditioned this way. And this is why I say we have too many internal enemies to confront white supremacy. Black America got a clean house. We got to have an internal war and kill a lot of each other. Not on no drug shit. This is on some like, all right, motherfucker, you're part of the problem. You got to go. Booyah. You know what I mean? Motherfucker, you hate yourself. You got to go. Booyah, motherfucker. Now, that kind of shit. Because at the end of the day, a black man who doesn't value the life of another black man, you're just as evil as a Klansman. You're just as evil as a black feminist. You're just as evil as a Nazi. And that's what you got going on. Black men don't value the life of other black men. And you got Chicago going on. You got white boy cops shooting us across the country. Because these white boy cops know black men don't value the life of other black men. And this is a result of, hey, many of us were raised in single-parent homes where we seen ghetto, nasty, black whore moms disrespect black male authority, talk down about black men in front of their little boys, and these little bastard-ass black boys grow up, and they have zero, zero respect or regard for black male authority. Their daughters, too, but I'm just focusing on black dudes. These same little black boys raised by their funky pussy single mom who picked a loser, they grow up and they just are just defiant and disrespectful towards other black men. And those same black dudes become adults, 30 and 40, and they be like, why are these youngsters doing this shit? Because they were raised by whores like your mom, who showed them that they don't gotta respect black male authority. So look, man, as black men, we are our own worst enemy. And you can ignore that all you want. You can say what you want to say. Racism's the problem. Hey, racism. It's racism. It's white supremacy. Fuck out of here, you dumb motherfuckers. Those are the degenerate loser ass black guys who fuck their lives up and have no fucking no direction, no options in life now. Because once you get a felony in this white supremacist society, they will lock you out of every fucking career you can possibly think of. That's just how this white supremacist society works. And a lot of these black idiots that talk like that have been locked out this have been locked out this society due to some dumb choices they made as kids or younger. And they have this self-defeatist mentality where it's like, man, blah, blah, blah. So it's like, man, at the end of the day, you got to stand as an individual black man. Trying to hook up and be all, you know, sticking together is some bullshit. Now, you come across some real black dudes that are about what you're about, making money, and y'all want to put some shit together, fine. But trying to defend the loser, degenerate class in black America, fuck that. Until these losers really be like, damn, I've been fucking up. Let me meet my brothers halfway, man. Fuck y'all losers, bro. Fuck you motherfuckers. And unfortunately, this is what the FBI wanted. They wanted black men to be divided and not like each other. This is what they wanted. After the fucking 70s, they did not want another politically active group of young black men in their 20s, like Huey P. Newton, Fred Hampton, and them. They didn't want that after the 70s. So they wanted a bunch of fucking skinny jean wearing fucking pill popping losers that you see today. They wanted a bunch of black guys to divide themselves up into gangs in their early 20s. That's what they wanted. Because it makes it easier for these dudes to be distracted. And that's what you got going on. So look, man, again, if you're a childless black man out here and you haven't contributed to the dysfunction you see, speak up, bro. Speak up, man, because you didn't create no babies out here. And it's 40%+ of us. You didn't sell drugs out here. You wasn't robbing people in your prime. You wasn't fucking around. You didn't waste time. So speak out and be like, fuck you, bitch. You picked these losers to get pregnant by. And look, I don't give a fuck who a bitch picks to get pregnant by. You just can't complain, you whore. That was your choice, your bed, you lay in it. Bottom line. I'm not tripping about who you picked. The only reason why I'm addressing it is because the black feminists are blaming all black men for single motherhood. And that should not be the case. You hoes should be blaming the small pool of losers that you're sharing. So yeah, man. Keep doing what you're doing if you're one of these productive, decent dudes out here, man. Don't be swayed by these self-haters and these, you know, hotep hustlers who basically are just looking to have company in their fucking deplorable situation. Instead of looking in the mirror and looking within and realizing that as black Americans, we have too many internal enemies. Tariq Nasheed, you can't confront white supremacy right now. You gotta clean your own house. You can't confront white supremacy, Tariq, when you got internal enemies who don't even like being black. And this is why I believe these dudes are all hotep hustlers. Because anybody with a brain can see that you cannot counter this white supremacy shit with fucked up black families. If you want to fucking counter white supremacy, if you want to fucking put fear in this white society, the best way to counter white supremacy is stable two-parent black families. When white motherfuckers see a mom, a dad, and kids together, that is a threat, you dumb motherfucker, Tariq. Again, the biggest threat to white supremacy is a stable two-parent black family. And these black whores know that shit. That's why they pick losers that they know they're going to walk out on them. Because these black chicks really don't want to counter white supremacy. They just want to a better position within this white supremacist, you know, structure. They want to be on the magazine covers and replace the white woman. These black chicks don't want to, you know, counter white supremacy, because if they did, they would have been raising decent, productive sons. Black boys that can read, write, do basic math and arithmetic, and compete with their Asian, white, and Hispanic counterparts. But these black single moms aren't raising black boys like that. And it'd be easy. The government already giving these bitches housing, free Section 8, and free food stamps, and health care. All these black single mothers had to do for the past 30 years was babysit, read, write, do homework, and produce good, educated black boys that would turn the tide within 3 to 5 years. 15 years, no. These single black mothers signed a contract basically to sell their sons out for female solidarity. Basically, these single mothers signed up to put female solidarity before the development of their own black boys, their own black sons in the house. And these same whores, complain when these black boys turn 18, 19, 20, and their daughters don't have, you know, eligible men that are worthy of being, you know, partners. Your mom raised these losers, you dumb whore. When you're going to ask your mom, why didn't she read and write with her sons when they were 4, 5, and 6 years old? Why didn't your mom pick a good man to get pregnant by so, you know, that boy could grow up to be a productive adult? Again, because these black bitches signed an agreement, a contract with the feminist movement in the 70s. They said, I'm going to sign up for female solidarity, girl power, and put that before the development of my own black son. And now here we are 30 years later. Those black boys are adults, many of them. And these black whores are dealing with the result of them not reading, writing, and taking the education of their black son serious. And these whores made their daughters suffer in that same way, because their daughters are now adults and they claim they can't find enough eligible black guys. Well, because your whore of a mom 30 years ago didn't read and write and pick a good father for that kid. Look, even if she didn't pick a good father, she could at least did homework and made sure the boy could read and write. No, these bitches are not about producing good black boys that will counter this feminist or this, you know, female matriarch. These black bitches have signed their souls over. And this is why 50 years from now, when black folks look at history and history is all condensed, they're going to see how evil and twisted these black chicks were in raising their own children and picking fathers. So like I said, man, as a childless black man, you better be out here telling the truth. Fuck biting your tongue. I don't give a fuck if your brother's a loser, your uncle's a loser, your cousins are losers. Fuck it. If you got to do a hard line on them, do a hard line on them. I'm talking about you as an individual black man. If you don't got no kids, if you ain't out here selling drugs, robbing motherfuckers, fuck that. Speak out. Because you got these black feminists, they are out here hell-bent on demonizing you. Demonizing you, and you haven't even contributed to none of this dysfunction. Again, you didn't sell drugs. You don't got no bastard babies out here. But they're still going to say, you ain't shit. This is their agenda. So, I mean, fuck it. You got to be like, all right, man, if you're going to be this fucking twisted and evil, I got to protect myself and my fucking image and my future. Bitch, I didn't tell you hoes to pick these losers to get pregnant by. I didn't tell you hoes to, you know, have babies and not read and write and pick good fathers for these kids. So I'm telling you, man, don't be sitting here silent, man, if you're a black dude and you don't got kids. And even if you're a black dude and you married and you living that good life and you got a good chick, I got a good-ass chick on my team. Badass good chick on my team. That don't mean I'm going to sit here and ignore this fucking assault on productive black men who are childless and who haven't contributed. Fuck that. I'm going to say what I'm going to say. Motherfuckers think that you automatically got to be a single, alone guy to be talking about black dysfunction in black America. No, man. Many of us are in stable relationships with badass, sexy chicks that are black or whatever race. But you can still see the dysfunction within black America, especially if you didn't contribute to the dysfunction. So yeah, man, just because you're in a relationship or you got kids that you take care of, that don't mean you can't voice your opinion about the fucked up shit you see. And if you on the other side and you don't got no kids and you just living life and making money and living a good productive life, you also should be like, fuck you bitches, I ain't getting none of you hoes pregnant. Don't blame me for the dysfunction you see in black America. So yeah, that's my video pretty much, man. Cause I realized that motherfucking these black feminists want to demonize all of us. Like, they want to put us all in this one group as Pookie and Ray Ray. Like, all y'all black dudes are Pookie and Ray. I'm like, come on, man. We're all responsible for single motherhood. Fuck out of here. So, look, I'm out. I'm done. Not too much I'm going to say. Oh, yeah, man, they got me. They got me on my last channel, Machiavelli. They flagged my last channel down. I forgot about that shit. I ain't tripping, though, because I got, like, multiple channels. Let these motherfuckers do this shit. They don't know how many fucking I got, like, fucking 15 different channels right now, man. So they delete. Man, I had over fucking 2,000 subscribers, but I kept it private. And motherfuckers deleted my shit yesterday. Yo, it's crazy because, like, when I got my second strike, what I did was I made private all of my controversial videos on my other War Stories account. Right? I made them all private so that I could preserve the channel, right? A day before my other strike was going to go away, some bitch went to one of my old videos and flagged it. I'm not tripping, you whore. You funky pussy bitch. Oh, man. I gotta go. I'm getting mad. I gotta go.
Show enough, that's how we do.
My finger fucking with my diamonds. Now peep a nigga climbing the charts. Ain't no fear in my heart. I represent it from the start and deep. My mama raised me as a G from birth. Be a hustling motherfucker till I seize my hearse. No doubt, I bust a shot for all my niggas in jail. All the young black males that gotta sling yayo, cause it's a hard life, nigga. Only thugs survive. Ain't no love, less a nigga slinging drugs and high. Conversations with these bitches on my mobile. Always in control and never let these bitches know you. And even though I'm getting high, a thug nigga getting by. Catching bitches spitting lies, I'm getting mine all day. I puff a blunt and parlay. Ask some dimes and we partay. Getting my dick licked twice and death to a trick's life. We can pursue this till my shit's right. Went from having fantasies to having hoes lead a man for me. There's no realer man than me. The city of Hopetown laced me. Broke my first case when them punk police tried to break me. Didn't think this shit was cute, so I got a lawsuit and made them punk police buy my coupe. This is how we do this.